With new exciting new mobile devices coming out every day, with new screen sizes and resolutions, it can be difficult making sure your images look best on every new device that hits the stores. Hi, I'm Tenghui from the Android UI Toolkit team, and I'm here to help you make your graphics look their best by telling you all the new vector graphics support we have added in Android 5.0 Lollipop. So what are vector graphics? And why would you want to use them? A normal bitmap represents images as a set of pixels in a grid. But with vector graphics, you can represent an image by describing the object geometrically. This means you can describe an image as a set of points, lines, and curves, along with all the associated color information. So how does this help you? The major advantage for vector graphics is image scalability. Take a look at these bitmap images. It looks fine on a low-res screen with a size of 100 by 100, but if you were put it on a high-res screen with a size of 400 by 400, while we can scale it up, you can see how it ends up looking blurry. So what many developers end up doing is creating multiple versions of each image for different display resolutions. This means more time to create the extra assets and more space taken up by the APK and on the device. But with vector images, you only need to create an image once as an XML file, and it can scale beautifully for all different DPIs for different devices. This not only saves spaces, but also simplifies maintenance. You can also use vector images for animation. Instead of having multiple series of images for all different DPIs, now all you need is just several XML files. Prior to the Lollipop release, if you ever want to draw anything using vector representation, you have to manually do it all in Java code, which was cumbersome. In Lollipop, we have two new classes to support vector graphics as our drawable resources. VectorDrawable and AnimatedVectorDrawable. VectorDrawable defines a static drawable object, while AnimatedVectorDrawable can add animations to the properties of a VectorDrawable. They are both subclasses of drawable, and they are both represented by XML files. Let's take a look at the XML structure of the VectorDrawable. Similar to the XVG format, each VectorDrawable can be represented as a tree hierarchy. Geometry is defined in the path tags, which are all the leaves of this tree. All the path description and drawing attributes are inside this tag. All paths will be drawn in the same order as they appear in the XML file. Transformation are defined in the group tag, which are the internal nodes of the tree. Note that for each path object, its transformation is inherited from all its ancestors' groups' transformation, applied in the order from the top to the bottom. Here is how it looks like in the XML file. You can clearly see the tree structure with those highlighted tags. Feel free to see more details in the link as shown below. Now, let's switch to the animated VectorDrawable. First, here is the diagram of its structure. On the top, the animated VectorDrawable's XML is essentially a little bit of glue, which connects the VectorDrawable's XML on the bottom left with the object animator's XML files over there on the bottom right, which describe the animations for the properties of VectorDrawable. To actually glue these two things up, animated VectorDrawable uses names to find a target object inside the VectorDrawable, like the G1 here. Notice that the target object to be animated can be either a group, a path, or the root tag, and they must be uniquely named. Then we can apply the specified object animator, like the a.sml in this example, to the target object we just find by name. Inside the object animator, we need to specify the property name to animate, like the rotation in this example, and the values for animation. Now, let's take a look at an example of animated VectorDrawable. First, Before adding the animations, the image on the left shows how the static vector drawable looks, and its XML code is on the right-hand side. If we add an animation of the group's rotation property like this, then we can get the rotation animations like this. If we add animation to the path's color attributes like this, then we can change the color of the sun from orange to red, like this. Moreover, if we animate the path data attributes like this, notice the value type now is set to the path type. Then we can change the shape of the sun as a path morphing in this cute animation. Now, let's talk about some of the trade-offs and performance aspects of these new classes. VectorDrawable has performance implications. With that in mind, my suggestions are, first, simplify the vector representation of an object. For example, avoid using many arg2 commands in the path data. Second, limit the image size of your VectorDrawable. Because these drawables are first drawn into bitmaps, then uploaded to the texture on the GPU, larger bitmaps means more memory and more time to upload. Practically, I would recommend using VectorDrawable for icons and buttons with reasonable sizes, for example, less than 200 by 200 dp. Third, don't update the attributes of VectorDrawable unless necessary. When there's no changes to the attributes like width, height, or alpha, our framework will be able to keep a cached bitmap without rejoining the path or re-uploading the texture to the GPU. For animated VectorDrawable, caching won't help here, so keep your animation short and sweet. Additionally, animating the path data attributes or the trim path attributes are heavy operations. Try to see if you can use transformation only for your animation to avoid those heavy operations. One last question you might have is, how will I create an XML file for the object for the VectorDrawable? Our tool team is hard at work on building new tools to help you generate these XML files. In the meantime, it's actually possible to create them by hand with just a little work. First, you can use any drawing program that can export SVG to create your image. Then, with a little cutting and pasting, then you can get the contents into your XML files. The VectorDrawable and Animated VectorDrawables are awesome classes that can help you to build a better looking, smaller app in an easier way. Please follow these links for more details on how to use them. Thank you.